So you've actually said to me before that the craniosacral rhythm or the cranial wave is actually the most accurate indicator of a person's overall well-being or health.
Correct.
How could you expand on that? Could you explain that a little bit to us?
Okay, as I explained before, that there are many different wave patterns and energy movements in the body. The core system, which in the body is the brain and the spinal cord, which affects all other function, it's like the major computer that of the body. Want to look at in a biomechanical model, and within this there is something called the cranial wave. And I would say that the discovery of the cranial wave and the work that Dr. John Upledger did in the 1970s to prove that the cranial wave does exist and exists in all mammals, not just humans, that is the core. You're able to diagnose and treat the major problems in the body. What it is, from my view, is the most significant discovery, because what it does, it links the world of the physical and the world of Newtonian physics and the way the body works as a machine. Of course, it's there's a physical wave that takes place in the brain and the spinal cord. On the other hand, it feels very, very comfortable in the world of quantum physics and the world of Eastern medicine, in the fact that it is energy, and it's an energy wave. So you have integration between energy into the structure of the body through the basic three layers of the brain, the spinal cord, that the energy basically goes through the skeletal system, the fascial system, and the fluid system. And the cranial wave is the manifestation and the evaluative tool to be able to diagnose the entire body on the fluid level, on the what we call the fascial level, the soft tissue level, and of the bone level. Now, we take all those three components and we can always break it down. And what we use with as a diagnostic tool of the cranial wave, we have four basic objective ways of finding if there's any sort of dysfunction in the body. We have, with a light touch, we can feel at every different level of the body, at every different point of the body, we measure four basic components. We measure for its symmetry, quality, amplitude, and rate of the cranial wave.
Right.
If there's some sort of restriction, whether it's on the bone, whether it's on the fascial organ level or fluid level or energetic level, the information we get, there may be some asymmetry, that one side may be more restricted than the other, as we're feeling this cranial wave that takes place about 6 to 10 times per minute. The quality, that we can feel for a smooth, even feel of the cranial wave, and that denotes that there's the organs and the body's working well, or there could be some sort of ratchety feeling, that they can call it, or sticky feeling, which means there's something underlying that's pulling and not allowing the full function. Also, we look at the amplitude. The amplitude, what is a very, very important component, is the overall strength of the system. People who have, for example, chronic fatigue, many of the elderly people who have decreased energy, people who have chronic illnesses, cancers, things like that, in general, their amplitude is much lowered. And so our job is that as cranial therapists is to encourage and to help revitalize the system so the body's self-healing mechanism could come into play. Now, and the last component is the component of the rate of the cranial wave. Now, in certain cases, that the rate is very, very high. We find that, for example, with autistic children, when we go into their heads. We don't really go into the heads with our hands. We feel and we find that there's tremendous restriction in the system. And what happens is the rate usually is very, very high. That there's the body is just trying to push out and in, and the cranial wave is trying to work, but there's some deep restrictions within the brain that's preventing the full even cranial wave to take place.
Okay,
so you have those four different components: the symmetry, quality, amplitude, and rate. And based on the three components of the body, of the fluid, of the internal organ, fascial system, which includes also the muscles, and then the third component of the bone and the joints. And from there, the cranial rhythm tells us on all those levels. One other component, and this is the link between the physical and the energetic spiritual, this is the work of Dr. Upledger when he talked about the cranial rhythm as a significance detector. The cranial wave is also, on a spiritual level, is the manifestation of the soul coming into the body. And you can get many answers on the energetic level or higher plane if you're attuned to that vibration, attuned to that conscious level or subconscious level or unconscious level, to tune into the what the basic soul of that person is feeling. And it's not what we call itself, the higher self. And the higher self is that part of that person that wants to go towards health and goes to healing. So many times you can even ask the cranial wave for certain questions and you will receive the answers, what's really significant and what's really correct for that person's process and person's healing process.
Because it's a manifestation of the person's higher self.
Exactly.
And so if you listen very sensitively and quietly and you allow the answer to come through,
there you go.
It comes through.
That's the key, is to be able to listen passively without any judgment, and to create a safe healing space for that person, enable for that still quiet voice to be able to manifest itself and give you the answers, because we believe that everybody has the self-healing abilities within them, that we call the inner physician, that higher self, to be able to help that person move forward in his healing process, whether it's on the physical, mental, or emotional or spiritual plane.